Dear brothers, respected elders, inshallah, our topic today, it's a celebration of this masjid. May Allah Azza wa Jal reward everyone that contributed to this masjid. It's humbling to see this bait of Allah Azza wa Jal, house of Allah Azza wa Jal erected. And it's humbling to see it in this country, inshallah. And my topic today is all around this. None of us, inshallah, is this presence guilty of anything today, but a celebration and a ni'mah of Allah Azza wa Jal that we're blessed with in this masjid. The Ummah, the Muslim Ummah, it's Ummah of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Ummah Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. In the opposition of Ahlul Bid'ah wal Furqah. This Ummah is the Ummah of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the followers of the Sunnah, and they hold in together in a group and a congregation in a Jama'ah. This is the name of this Ummah, Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. In the opposition, in the opposite direct of Ahlul Bid'ah, the people of innovation and people of differences and tafarruq, Ahlul Bid'ah wal Furqah. Because when somebody innovated a bid'ah, created something new in deen, others, they come start branching out of him and branching and so on and so forth until they might make multi groups from one group. But the mainstream of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah stays on. And the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they identify to one thing, identify to the masjid, to the masjid. And that's identity, they identify to the masjid. What? And this is why Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he takes his family, he says to Allah Azza wa Jal, قال الله عز وجل ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم عند بيتك المحرم لماذا why oh Allah عز وجل I migrated and I put my kids in a valley dry valley with no greens in with no trees with no nothing to cultivate but ليقيموا الصلاة I want them to perform salat. For this, send some people to them. فَاجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ For the single and the sole purpose of إِقَامَةُ الصَّلَاةِ So Ibrahim is saying to Allah Azza wa Jal, send few people around them to give them company so they can steadfast on their deen. ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة فاجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم وارزقهم من الثمرات لعلهم يشكرون Oh Allah, I took my family and I put them in a desert, in a way, in a valley, there is nothing grows in it. Please, for them to perform salat, send some people to give them company and some tamarat, some fruits and veggies to them, maybe they be thankful and grateful to you. As an ummah, we identify to the masjid. And here in little local, much blessed community, do you know so and so? When you ask, do you know Brother Sharif? He will tell you, yes, I know him, I met him in Holland Park Masjid. Do you know this brother? I met him in that masjid. And this is why we identify the result of it, identify to the masjid. Do you know so and so? I met him in so and so masjid. We identify to the masjid. The masjid, when a Muslim moves to a state nowadays, subhanAllah, yesterday only heard it. When a Muslim and his heart connected to the masjid, and he's one of the seven that Rasulullah said, from Allah, the one that Allah, they will have the privilege of the shade of Allah Azza wa Jal in the day of Qiyamah, in the day of judgment, where will be no shade, but Allah Azza wa Jal shade, one of them, his heart connected to the masjid. His heart connected, pulled up to the masjid. When a Muslim nowadays moves a state to try to change a state for a job or for other reasons, he will ask, where I go? Bristol? I'm going to Melbourne. Where I should go? You want to go to masjid because to Dandenong? Or to Bristol? Or to Fokkner? Or Werribee? That's how when they find, because his heart's connected to the masjid and he wants the benefit of them. That's why we identify the masjid. And this result we say, as a result of this we say, a masjid makes a community, not the community builds a masjid. Put the masjid and our community will be there. A masjid builds a community, not vice versa. Why we call it masjid? And just to recap, maybe this mentioned before me here, it's called masjid? Why is not marka? We make ruku' in it, we stand in it, why is not a marka? A masjid. Why? Because Allah Azza wa Jal, one of the reasons is Allah Azza wa Jal created Adam alayhi salam and his offsprings, created Adam and his dhurriyyah, and he made walaqad karramna bani Adam. And Allah Azza wa Jal give them dignity and honor. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. And there is nothing dignified in a Muslim person's face. There is nothing dignified like a person's face. So if Allah Azza wa Jal made the masjid, Allah Azza wa Jal made the masjid to put whatever blessed and the best and the most highest person is his forehead, to put it down in the for the most honored, most dignified Allah Azza wa Jal, to ask his slave to put it down on this place. That is called a masjid, because we make sujood in it, and to put our best thing, best part of our body, which is the face and on the ground for Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is where the similarity comes between al-musalli in the masjid and al-malaika. Because they share between them three things. Musalli and Musalli in the masjid and al-Malaika, they have three things in common. One is sujood. Malaika always making sujood to Allah Azza wa Jal. Always making sujood to Allah Azza wa Jal. And secondly, tasbih. That's why a masjid is a masjid. Because the Muslim is performing the highest form of ibadah to Allah Azza wa Jal, which is sujood. And here Rasulullah says, أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٌ فَأَكْثِرُوا فِي الدُّعَاءِ. The best, the closest a Muslim to Allah Azza wa Jal when he's making sujood. That's why he insists and emphasize in dua in that moment. Take advantage of it. So this is why in the masjid, in Sumi Masjid, and it's a symbol of unity for the Ummah. A masjid is a symbol of unity for the Ummah. And one third thing that Al-Malaika Rasulullah said to us to do, like the Malaika do, Rasulullah said, أَلَا تَصُفُّونَ كَمَا تَصُفُّ الْمَلَائِكَ. Why didn't you make saf rows like Al-Malaika does in front of Allah Azza wa Jal? They said, how, Ya Rasulullah? He said, they complete the first saf and they stand straight. They complete the first saf by first saf and they stand straight. أَلَا تَصَفُّونَ كَمَا تَصَفُّ الْمَلَائِكَ. We stand in the masjid when we make safuf like al-malaika. And this is what we have common between us and the malaika in the masjid. أَلَا تَصَفُّونَ. A symbol of unity. And the masjid is a sign and a symbol of unity for the ummah. When al-masjid al-dirar, alhamdulillah, doesn't apply any to anything in here in Queensland. When this munafiq, he was called Abu Amir al-Rahib. He was jealous. He was jealous to see the Ummah of Rasulullah together. He was jealous and envious. He was a munafiq. And he tried to create fitna and he went and made the masjid. And he was from Al-Khazraj and he went to his people and he said, look, let's go and divide this Muhammad and his followers. And Rasulullah was busy at the time with the battle of Tabuk, and he went and he did and he asked his people to make a masjid, and he asked Rasulullah, we made an effort and we made a masjid. Please, come and make salat in it. Please come and make salat in it. Just want to see you, the blessing of Rasulullah, he was saying to Rasulullah, just want to see the blessing of you, bless, come and bless our masjid. And because wasn't done for the right cause of Allah Azza wa Jal, because wasn't built, and the foundation wasn't for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, the wahi, the revelation comes straight to Rasulullah. لمسجد أسس على التقوى من أول يوم أحق أن تقوم فيه. And Allah says, لا تقوم فيه أبدا. Don't ever, O Muhammad, stand in this masjid, because it's built on the, with the bad intention, built to serve division of the ummah. لا تقوم فيه أبدا. Don't ever stand in it. Don't ever come around it. La masjid usisa ala taqwa, the masjid you should go to, that masjid is masjid Quba, that masjid, it was its foundation built on fi sabilillah azza wa jal. La masjid usisa ala taqwa min awwal yawm ahqqu an taquma fihi. Who's in that masjid fihi rijalun yuhibbuna an yatatahharu wallahu yuhibbul mutahhirin. Go to the Quba Masjid, because there is people, there is men there. They only seek the right, they have the right intention, and they went there to fill up the house of Allah Azza wa Jal. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, خير بقاع الأرض مساجدها وشر البقاع أسواقها. The best spot on this earth is the masajid. The best spot, Rasulullah said, in this and on the face of earth is the masajid, and sharru al-biqa, and the worst spot is the aswaq. Not because the aswaq has cursed, so people they don't do trade and don't do business, no way, but because of the connect and disconnect. It's the connection and disconnection factor in there, because al-masjid can connect you with Allah Azza wa Jal. Al-Masjid connects you with Allah Azza wa Jal, and the Aswaq take you away from Allah Azza wa Jal. Because you used to be taking oath and making yameen, saying, wallahi it's this, wallahi it's that, and the cheating and all that stuff happened in the markets, and the raise of voice, and the sharru al-aswaq, sharru al-biqa'i aswaquha. Naam. وَأَنَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُو مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. And in the conversation, what was happening about in Surah Al-Jinn, Allah Azza wa Jal and Al-Jinn, they came to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and they said, how can we pray and follow you to pray behind you while we are away from you? And Allah Azza wa Jal sent this ayah, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. The masajid are for Allah Azza wa Jal and for Him only. فَلَا تَدْعُوا, don't call anybody, don't worship anybody beside Allah Azza wa Jal. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. نعم, يُذْكَرُ فِيهَا وَحْدَهُ. The mention of the name of Allah Azza wa Jal, only mention in it. وَيُعْبَدُ فِيهَا, and worship only, and تُبْنَى لَهُ وَحْدَهُ. A masjid is a focal center, a focal of the Muslim, and it's a center point. It should be full of life, not commercial, not cimmerian occasions and marriages, not for ceremony. And those ones, I met one person one day, and I was delivering meat to some shops, and I met somebody, and I found out he's Algerian. I said, where you been? We never know you. Because only when people come to the masjid. And I said, please come live in South Brisbane area next to the masjid, we can see you. He said, no. I wanted fun. He said, I wanted fun. I'm a funny person. I still want to enjoy myself. And masjid, it's not, it's all full of seriousness. Now, full of life, not to come. And we tell to those ones, Al-Imam al-Shatibi, rahimahullah azza wa jal, said this wise word, اعبدوا الله اضطرارا اختيارا كما تعبدكم اضطرارا. You have no way but to worship Allah Azza wa Jal go and worship him voluntarily, because you're going to come anyway. And for those ones, they said, stay away from the masjid. Stay away from the masjid. I don't want to go around the masjid. I still want to enjoy myself. Now those ones, we tell them, look, if you don't come, we'll bring you. If we don't bring you alive, we'll come dead anyway. So if you have no choice but to come to the masjid, come voluntarily. Now, and the masjid, it's a lighthouse. It's a lighthouse. It's a light, serves like a lighthouse in the community. And wallahi, not for every other masjid. It's all our masjids like this. Wallahi, the example of the Gold Coast Masjid. It has a community, everyone connected to it. And makes you remember what the role of the masjid and the services it provides in the community. Now, and the masjid is a sign of testimony of Iman. A masjid, it's a sign and testimony of Iman. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا رأيتم الرجل يعتاد المساجد فاشهدوا له بالإيمان. If you see a person go regular to the masjid, اشهدوا له بالإيمان. Witness is a mu'min. Witness is a mu'min. If somebody comes and complain to you about so and so, say, no, he's a mu'min. I don't think I saw him in the masjid. I see him all the time in the masjid. I don't think he's one of these persons to do this thing. فَاشْهَدُوا لَهُ بِالْإِيمَانِ وَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمُ اِقْرَأُوا إِنْ شِئْتُمْ. Read, if you want. إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. The one they fill the masajid, the one they build the masajids, those the ones they have iman in Allah Azza wa Jal and the hereafter. Now, and masjid served in the Rasulullah times and after him as educational center. The ulama, the great ulama, came out from the masjid. And marriages, they used to be in the masjid. Rasulullah, even Sa'd ibn Ubadah, when he was injured in one of the battles, he made the shed for him in the masjid. It served as a clinic. And so on, and so on. House of Allah Azza wa Jal, he's the most generous. Rasulullah said, Al-Masjidu Baytullah. Al-Masjidu Baytullah. Wa haqqun ala Allahi man qasada baytahu an yukrimah. Rasulullah said, Al-Masjid, it's a house of Allah Azza wa Jal. And if you knock on the, if you go to the most generous person, he obviously, he's going to give you something. Obviously, if you go and visit somebody generous, you'll get something. If you get a cup of tea, you'll get a dinner. And with Allah Azza, you get what you get. Now, collective responsibility, someone somehow will take care of it. We appreciate the whole community, we appreciate the work some people they do behind the scene. And that's what من بنى لله مسجدا. This is shouldn't our focus in working or serving the masjid shouldn't go anywhere else but in the house of from a house of Al-Jannah. من بنى لله مسجدا. If somebody comes in here, what I have in it, when we contributing to the masjid, to the Bina al-Masjid, your nafs will ask you a question. What I will have in it? Will I be a member of the board? Will I will be pulling the strings? If these questions, what's for me there for it? When you say help in building a masjid or serving in a masjid, when the questions and nafs, when your nafs start asking you these questions, you tell her a house in Jannah. A house in Jannah. Sometimes Shaytan, when we see Bill Gates and whatever, whoever there, putting this money in their and charity and this, we go and follow them and we say, look, I want my legacy. Your legacy after death is a house in Al-Jannah. Your legacy, sometimes the nafs and Shaytan comes to us, why I'm doing this one for? And when it comes to the masjid, I will say a house in Al-Jannah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. We don't say the collective responsibility فرض الكفاية, because we come and see the masjid is clean all the time, somebody else will be doing it. No, the collective responsibility is equal to no responsibility. The collective responsibility equal to no responsibility. When we say someone will do it, why it's not me? We say the opposite question, why it's me? No. When it comes to the tidiness and the building of the masjid, why it's not me? Not why it's me? Why it's not me? I will ask this question. Not always there is, we go into the masjid and we see it clean and the electricity there and the air conditioner running. And when the air conditioning turns off a little bit, we start whinging, it's so hot, why it's sweating? No, not because someone will come and do. No, why it's not me? Now, taharatul masjid wa ta'zeemuh. One of the obligations is, and we keep the masjid clean, taharatul masjid, and we glorify it. We make it the best of things. The best in our time. Qala Allah ta'ala, ya bani adama khudu zinatakum inda kulli masjid. Not none of us here, but sometimes we come in Salat al-Fajr, just we throw the blanket away, we come to the masjid, we smell what we smell. Rasulullah said, إِنَّ الْمَلَائِكَةَ لَتَتَأَذَّى مِمَّا يَتَأَذَّى ابْنُ آدَمٍ مِنُ ابْنُ آدَمٍ إِنَّ الْمَلَائِكَةَ لَتَتَأَذَّى مِمَّا يَتَأَذَّى مِنُ ابْنُ آدَمٍ. Rasulullah used to have a libas for Jumu'ah, used to have a clothes, separate clothes for Jumu'ah and Ayyad. And the ulama, they always used to have the tazkin. And we come just to the masjid the way we want to come. And this is not to push away the tradies and the brothers, they always in doing work. No, but we are just this, at least we consider how we come to the masjid. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى يَا بَنِي آدَمَ خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ. Do your best in cleanliness and hygiene and when you come to the masjid. خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدٍ. And this is the opposite to al-mushrikeen. When they used to come to the masjid, they went the opposite, the extreme way. When they used to come to Masjid al-Haram, they used to say, no, we don't want to make tawaf with the dirty clothes. And they used to take their clothes and they tawaf, a'udhu billah, without a dress. And Allah Azza wa Jal said, ya bani Adam, khudu zinatakum inda masjid, kulli masjid. Take care of what you dress. And even subhanallah al-azim, the ulama, they said, even if you have a singlet, they question whether you choose to dress up. It's not the minimum, it's the maximum. You say, my awra, it's covered, why? And I'm in a singlet. Now, khudu masjid, do you go to the court with the singlet? Do you go for a job interview with the singlet? If Allah, what about Al-Kareem, his house? Do you come and visit, go, these people, they go Christmas party, they don't go with the singlets? They go in these functions with the singlets. If somebody invites you for his daughter or his son's wedding, you go with the singlets and you don't care what you wear, what you smell. Well, Allah Azza wa Jalla's house better, deserves better. Allah Azza wa Jalla deserves better. Better. Now, ya bani. Qala al-Hasan al-Basri. عن المساجد تعظم ويرفع شأنها وتطهر من الأنجاس. عمر رضي الله الحسن البصري said, and the masjid is an obligation for the masjid to be cleaned and to be cleaned for everything والأقدار. And عمر رضي الله عنه narrated that Rasul sallam, he said, when a person comes smells so bad, he will say, look, go to al-Baqi and pray with us. من أكل من هذه الشجرة من أكل منها فلا يقربن مصلانا. Whoever eats raw onions or garlic doesn't come to the masjid. And this is an qiyas and whatever similar to it. لأن why الملائكة تتأذى مما يتأذى ابن آدم. Whatever بني آدم, the person next to you doesn't like, الملائكة doesn't like it too. And they are next to you. And you don't want to smell, vibrate smell, bad smell to them. قال عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه ثم إنكم أيها الناس تأكلون من شجرتين ولا أراهما إلا خبيثتين هذا البصل والثوم. You guys eat some. عمر رضي الله تعالى said, you people eat some two trees, two veggies, and they are so smell so bad. وما أراهما إلا خبيثين. I don't like them. As Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do, and I think they are the onions and the garlic. قال العلماء وإذا كانت العلة في إخراجه من المسجد أنه يتأذى به ففي القياس إن كل من تأذى به جيرانه. And if somebody comes and does harm to the masjid, even subhanAllah, I was looking for this fatwa. And if someone harms the musallis in the masjid, we tell him, al-maslahatu al-ammah muqaddamatun ala al-maslahati al-khasah. The public interest always comes first before the individual interest. The public interest, if somebody brings his baby crying, we tell him, brother, you're coming to pray, but the public interest and the public benefit comes before, takes preference of the individual preference. So, and I like something with nowadays, a person responsible to run a family, responsible to drive a car, responsible to do a business or to have a job, and can't be responsible once to turn his mobile off all the time. What responsibility? You are trusted to run a family, to take care of so many serious things, and one minor thing, just a shot to remember, to turn off. And I like this saying in one of the messages in Arabic, اقطع الاتصال بالمخلوق واتصل بالخالق. اقطع الاتصال بالمخلوق واتصل بالخالق. Disconnect with the creator, connect with the creator and disconnect with the creation. Disconnect with Allah Azza wa Jal and disconnect from the others. And that's what difference between the masjid and a souq. A masouq, you hear the mobile off here and here. But in the masjid, it's disconnection and connection. Disconnect with the outside world and connect with Allah Azza wa Jal. And at the end, وفي صحيح مسلم عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من غدا إلى المسجد أو راح أعد الله نزلا له نزلا في الجنة كلما غدا أو راح. أبو هريرة narrated that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever comes to the masjid and go, those ones they don't see any importance to come to the masjid. For those ones they come and go from to the masjid, every time they come and go to the masjid, Allah will make a palace for them in Jannah. A palace. Do we trust these words? Are they the truth? وَبَغِيَ وَاللَّهِ they are true from the mouth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَاللَّهِ كُلَّمَا غَدَى أَوْرَاحِ whenever he comes and goes out from the masjid, Allah will build for him a palace in Jannah. And someone will come and tell me, I don't go to that masjid because someone there, my ex-wife's husband is there. What nonsense. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ it's for Allah Azza wa Jal. If somebody sold you a car before and you find it dead, a bad deal, a lemon, don't abandon the masjid because of that. If you come to Mabrook and you thought he robbed you because he sold you expensive chops, don't abandon the masjid because it is there. Because وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. I don't go to that masjid because so and so, I don't like him, he's there. It's at the house of Allah Azza wa Jal. And believe me, wallahi, it's a voice of shaitan to make you stay at home, and then you will abandon the whole salat. And you will abandon the whole salat. وَرَوَىٰ عَنِ الْحَكَمْ نُعْمَيْرِ صَاحِبُ رَسُولَهُ. And for those ones, we call them in Arabic, junudul khafa. Junudul khafa. Those ones, the soldiers of secret soldiers, they doing the work to keep the masajid alive and to keep it serviced as we see it now, neat and nice. Al-Bara ibn Azib radiallahu ta'ala anhu went to Asham and he was concerned. He went to Syria and he was concerned about the darkness in the masjid, in the masjid al-Nabawi. And he saw the darkness, he went there and he got some robes and he got some oil and he put the candles and he hung them up in the Rasulullah so impressed. And he came and he saw the lights with the candles hanging on the ceiling. And Rasulullah was so impressed with his work. And he said, who did this? Who did this? Al-Bara said, someone said, Al-Bara ibn Azib did. Rasulullah said, wallahi, if I have a daughter, I will marry her to you. I will give you my daughter. This is what you deserve when you look after the masjid. He said, wallahi, if a daughter, I will give it to you from what you brought the likeness into the masjid. And then another sahabi came, and he said, oh, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have my daughter and give it to as a reward to Al-Bara ibn Azib. So those junud al-khafa, congratulations, you are staying up at night when everybody is asleep. Jazakumullah khair for defending this. Now, وروى عن الحكيم بن عمير صاحب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كونوا في الدنيا أضيافا كونوا في الدنيا أضيافا being on the face of this earth like a guest واتخذوا المساجد بيوتا and make the masajid like your houses وعودوا قلوبكم الرقة and make your heart so soft وأكثروا التفكر and make more of the tafakkur contemplation and walbuka wala takhtalifu bikum al-ahwa and then don't let the desires divide you. Don't let your desires divide you. Tabnuna ma la taskunun. You build what you don't live in, what you're not going to live in. Watajma'una ma la ta'kulun and accumulate what you can't eat. Watu'ammiluna ma tudrikun. And you wish what you can't get. And oh son of Adam, I'll say this, a human being's life is divided between two things, two shares. When you're young, you will say, I wish I would have done this, I can get this answer. When you're over 50 or over 60, you will say another wish, I wish I didn't do. And Allah said in this sense, كلا إنها كلمة هو قائلها ومن ورائهم برزخ إلى يوم يبعثون. When the day of judgment, when a person from أهل الجهنم, he will say, oh Allah, send me back, I'll do good. Allah Azza replies, كلا إنها كلمة هو قائلها. It's only a word they will say, even if we bring him back, even if we send him back to dunya, he will do the same thing. A human being's life is divided between your wishes. Between two wishes, one when you're young, I wish I do. And the second half is, I wish I've done this, I wish I didn't do this. يبن آدم, اعمل ما شئت فإنك ملاقيه. افعل ما شئت فإنك ملاقيه. Do whatever you like, you will meet it inshallah in the day of judgment. وكن كما شئت, and be the way you like. فكما تدين تدان. Whatever you do will get it back. فإن الدين لا يفنى وإن الديان لا يموت. واحبب ما شئت فإنك مفارقه. واحبب ما شئت فإنك مفارقه. واعمل ما شئت فإنك ملاقيه. عباد الله إن الله قد أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى فيه بملائكته فقال عز من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر دينك وانصر إخواننا الذين يجاهدون لإعلاء كلمتك يا الله. اللهم اكشف ما بإخواننا في سوريا وفي اليمن وفي فلسطين وفي كل بقاع الأرض ما بهم من أذى يا الله. اللهم انصرهم على أعدائهم واشف مرضاهم وتقبل شهداءهم. اللهم كلهم فلا ناصر لهم إلا أنت. اللهم كلهم فلا ناصر لهم إلا أنت يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم وأقيم الصلاة.